on the side, like a straight line. There's a lot of hacks to get the line straight. I don't think it's that hard, but you just kind of come down on the sides. So that's the first step. Sometimes I do a little on the end just because mine's a little long and pointy. Finally, your jawline. Now, as we get older, obviously, you get the neck jawline issues, and it's scary. So a way to combat that is to contour your jaw. And I can show you how to do it. My best suggestion for everyone, as if you're a novice, is to practice, practice, practice. And then when you first start to do it and wear it out, do it at night because the lighting is much more forgiving. And that way you can kind of get better at it before you really take it ready for prime time during the day. So you want to go to the very edge of your jaw, kind of come down from your ear, and you don't want to go under. You want it to be on your jawline. You don't need a lot of product to do this. And then again, take a big fluffy brush and blend. So I don't know if you can see, but it just gives you a little bit more of a chiseled jawline. If you do it wrong and it's daytime, it's really frightening. So, like I said, nighttime. Next, we're going to move on to highlighting. Am I going too fast?
No, Kira, we have like 2 or 3 more minutes. Can we do
Okay, I'm
highlighting?
going to speed it up.
2 minutes?
Highlighting.
Okay.
Okay. All right. Great. Here we go.
Sorry, I could talk for a while. Highlighting. So you want to highlight down the, you want to take like a fluffy brush. You want to highlight down the center of your nose.
And this is with the lighter color, I presume.
Right. This
Right.
is the
Yeah.
highlight part. This is
Great.
so.
Can't leave any of the details out with
Okay, I'm sorry.
the
So the
students like me.
contouring gives you that shadows, and it gives you that chiseled look. The highlighting brings everything out. So you want to go to the very top of your cheekbone and go back. If you have crow's feet, don't try to stay away from the crow's feet. And you can also go up over your brow a little bit. So I don't know if you can see that highlight on me, but
Yeah, that's really good.
yeah, so that's the light highlight from the light kit. You don't want to get anywhere around your under eye or your nasal labial fold. You want to stay up here and below if you have any crow's feet. If not, don't worry about it. And then come up. You got your nose. You can do a little on your chin, your Cupid's bow, and you are good. How's that? Under 2 minutes?
Yes, Kira,
Okay.
that was awesome. That was
Thank you
awesome.
so much.
Thank you
I
so
can't
much.
wait to come back into the shop when you're reopened. I've been walking my dog down Elm Street, looking in the window,
Oh,
waiting
yes,
for
I
everyone
know.
to come back.
Hopefully.
So, yeah.
I'm longing to have people again come in. Yeah.
Kira, this was great. I went from not knowing what contouring is to wanting to contour my jaw.
Yeah.
So
Oh, see?
this is
See?
awesome.
I want to contour my body.
So I just want to say that everybody can still get the contour kits, light, medium, or dark. And then once we reopen again, we're obviously going to be doing them custom blended. Yeah, that's it.
And where do they reach you
Kara,
online,
thank you so
Kira?
much.
Where do they
Say it
reach you?
again.
Where do they reach you online?
So we're at blendbeauty.com, and they're under House Blends in the store.
Great.
Thank
Thank you so
you.
much, Kira.
Thank you. That was
You're
great. Thank you,
welcome.
Kira.
Thank you so
Take
much.
care,
We'll
everyone.
see you.
You too. You too.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Now we're it's auction time. It's auction time. We are going to bring in Janice Rich from Janice's Closet in Westfield. And Janice is going to be auctioning. Well, I'm gonna let her tell you what she's auctioning off because it's and who it's benefiting, because it's really, really cool. So, hi. Yes, do we have
you? Can you hear me?
Yes.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
Awesome. I'm so excited about the cons we're in, though. I'm still
like, here, can't wait to open back up.
I was like, I didn't bring my kid. I can't practice. Good afternoon, everyone. I'm actually Stevie. I'm Janice's sister, and this is her daughter, Angelina.
Hi.
Unfortunately, Janice couldn't be here this afternoon, and we are extremely grateful for Downtown Westfield and the United Fund for their efforts in keeping Westfield a great place to live, shop, and just stroll through. We are the Salvatore Ferragamo bag.
So we donated a Salvatore Ferragamo bag to support small independent businesses within Westfield that have been devastated by everything that has been going on recently through the pandemic. And you have an opportunity to possibly win the bag if you donate to the Westfield United Fund, and under the honor section, you put in Ferragamo bag. We will be announcing the winner at 5, so good luck. We're also honoring through June 30th, 10% of all gross sales will be going to the direct assistance, compromised families, and food residents, and or of the staff of the Veterans Committee of the Living Center in Lyons, New Jersey. For everyone who knows us and what we've been doing, on behalf of Janice and the VA staff and the veterans, we thank you for all your contributions, your coupons, and we were able to feed a lot more for a lot less. We really appreciate that. So a little bit about us. We opened in September of 2017, and we have been open since. Well, obviously not now because we can't be, but we unfortunately. But you can find us on Instagram, Facebook, or our website to view items to purchase or purchase through the website. And we do offer curbside pickup, or we ship for free to your house. We will be open for curbside pickup starting the 2nd of June, hopefully, from Tuesday to Friday, hours 3 to 6. And as further develops occur, we will be adding more days and hours so that you can get your wonderful items. As you can see behind us, we offer a wide variety of new and pre-loved designer handbags, shoes, accessories, and much, much more. And they are by brands like, as you can see, Louis Vuitton, Gucci, Chanel,
Burberry.
A lot of, and at a huge discount compared to retail prices. So, you know, it's a pretty good deal most of the time, you know? So, yeah.
Where do you all get your merchandise?
We actually get our merchandise through a large variety of people, people from Westfield, people. We actually have a lot of people that are from New York, and they used to come in when they were able to before the pandemic to bring in things from people in Westfield, from people in New Jersey. We have a lot of clients actually from other states such as California and Florida that will actually fly in and bring things in.
And shop in town, which is nice.
Which is so, so nice because
yeah, great support.
Yeah. It's really nice because if there's a there's obviously, you know, many restaurants downtown, and if they have a longer wait some nights, they'll be like, oh, please go to the other businesses in the area while you wait so that you can support other small businesses, because that's what you really, we need to support each other.
Yes.
Which is very, very nice.
So all people need to do to get a chance to win that Ferragamo bag is go on to the Westfield United Fund?
Yes. They need to
make a donation, right?
Yes. And in the honor section, you have to make sure you write Ferragamo bag so that you have the opportunity to.
What is the retail on that bag?
I'm pretty sure it's $2,200, and it's like a brand new bag. So you could, you know, donate $50 or $100 or more if you can, and you can get a $2,200 bag for obviously a small, small fraction of the actual
retail.
Yeah,
for being involved, you can get a really nice little bag.
Oh, that's amazing.
Thank you so much. You never know what you can get by giving.
Thank you both so much.
WestfieldUnitedFund.org.
WestfieldUnitedFund.org, which they have been so incredible.
They've been amazing. We love supporting them.
So people should go on, stay on the webinar. and keep watching the presentations and go on your phone or your tablet, go on to Westfield United Fund, make that donation between now and 4:30 to be entered in for the band.
Yes.
Thank you so much. Right.
Thank you for having
us. Thank you for having us.
Thank you.
Thank you
both very much.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you both very much.
Thank you.
Okay, now we are on to our next presentation. We are going to bring on Terry D'Annunzio from J. McLaughlin. I think Terry was one of the first merchants I actually met in downtown Westfield on my very first day when we shot that cool We Love Westfield video. And Terry's gonna be talking about and showing you how to wear scarves in your hair. One of the new trends. So Terry, if you're with us, take it away. Terry, are you with us?
Yes, she's trying to unmute.
She's trying to unmute. It's the old unmute trick.
Yeah, there's a trick to it.
Right.
Thank you.
There you go, there you are.
Hi.
I had five screens and none of them were you all.
Oh, hi Terry, long time no see.
I know, I got to see you walking in town.
Yeah, I just saw right 2 hours ago.
So I am so glad to be with you guys. Thank you all, as everyone has said, for doing this. I do have to get on my phone and enter that drawing.
Yes.
Because I'm all about a good bag. So I'm going to spend some time with you today just showing you how to, I don't know, give you a nice spring look or update, maybe just a plain top that you're wearing. I'm going to show you how to wear some scarves. So I wanted to show you just real simple. This is our reed scarf. It is actually 100% wool, but it's super soft. And a real easy way to wear it, Shelly, you can see if you can do this. You just hold it.
Can I be following you?
You can.
This is a lovely J. McLaughlin scarf that was dropped off for me so I can play along.
You can play when you do it. So what I do is I just kind of gather it long. You have a rectangle, right?
Yeah,
so you put your hands right there and you lay it in front of you. Go lay it right across your neck, go to the back and crisscross and bring the tails in front. You got it. Now loosen up your neck and there you go. And now if you want, sometimes I like to pull it tight and get long tails, or you could take the ends and you could even tie them a little bit. And then you get a really pretty kind of gathering like that. So this is our reed scarf. It's just really easy. You'll see that we do this scarf in every pattern, that when you see our pretty shirts, we often have the scarf in the same pattern. So this one's really cute. And this is called the reed scarf. Now, sometimes when you're out in a restaurant and maybe you have short sleeves or you have a sleeveless dress, and you just need something to cover your shoulders. This scarf is called the tapestry scarf. It's so pretty. It has little tassels on the end. And you can use this as a shawl. So again, just by putting it in the middle, slide it over your shoulders and open it up. And look, you have a really simple shawl. It's just like that. And if you look, see, it just kind of covers your back. Now you might say, oh, I wouldn't use a pattern as a shawl. It comes in a really pretty, it's white, has a little blue trim. So a little Westfield blue there, right? Little blue devils. So, and this is our tapestry scarf. Just another easy way to wear it. So now Bob was talking about this, wearing a scarf as a hair scarf. So my daughter told me that this is all the rage now, hair scarves. So this helps if you start with it folded kind of narrow. And again, I didn't do it real formal. I just have it tight. This is the Giselle scarf. This is a version of the scarf that Shelly has. This one's pink and orange. Shelly has royal blue and navy. So now while you're doing this, sometimes it looks a little funny. You start, put it over your head, right? Don't laugh because we're not done yet. You're gonna tie it in the back. And then you just kind of pull some of your hair out over it. And you have a really cute hair scarf. Think like one of those old movies where they're riding in the
convertible, and she looks all put together. Now,
thinking Rhoda or
yes, Rhoda, right?
Mary Tyler Moore.
Right. But what this is good for, and Linda, you were saying this, it's a great way to cover your gray hair.
Oh.
Cover your roots if you don't want to do your hair that day. And right. You just play. You can make it wide to cover your whole head. And you just have the tails right here. And this scarf is 100% silk. So it's really light and really soft. Some people even do it like a babushka, but it's just a nice, easy way, you know, just to do something different. So all three scarves are on my Instagram, where you can find it at stylist underscore Terry underscore J Mac. And you can DM me there. You can call the store and they're all available for curbside pickup or at home delivery. And we auctioned off, we had a raffle for a scarf for one person who registered. How you doing with the headscarf, Shelly?
I was looking like Stevie Van Zandt. So
you just have to play with it a little bit, right?
I'll go to the neck thing for now.
The wrap looks great. So we auctioned off a scarf, and I'm happy to say that Claudia Step Palladino is the winner of a scarf. Yay.
We like winners.
Right? All of our scarves retail for $98. You can find them on our website and then the national website. But if you call the store, we can sell that to you and keep the business right here in Westfield.
Let's do that. Exactly.
You, Shelly.
No, Terry, thank you. You're amazing.
And, thank you so much.
Absolutely. I love to cover the gray tip. Thank you.
Yeah. Right? Cover the gray. And I can't wait to see everybody again and to have people in the store. We're ready to open the champagne and just celebrate together.
Yeah, we can't wait.
Absolutely.
Yep.
Okay.
Thank you, Terry.
Thank you. Thank
you for participating.
Great to see you.
And actually, this is a really good segue to our next presentation, because if by chance you're not wearing one of Terry's scarves to cover your gray, the next presenter is going to go into, I think, 10 ways to hide your gray. 10 ways? Okay, that's way more than I ever thought there would be. So Claudia Matos from Elegant Image Salon is our next presenter, and hopefully her salon will be reopening soon, like the other salons and the other non-essential retail stores that have been closed. So we're hoping that all of this happens in June, sooner rather than later. So right now I'd like to bring up Claudia.
Hello, everyone.
Hi.
So I'm so happy to be here. Thank you guys so much for having me on. I am so eager to see everyone in person. It's just like unreal. This has been very long, 2 months. So I just also wanted to commend you all for doing a fantastic job. I've had my business here in Westfield for 17 years. And I must say, this is probably the first time that I feel the most supported, not only by the town, the residents, but you know, also all of you. And you guys are doing a great job. So thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, Claudia.
Okay, now to the fun part. Yes, there are 10 ways to cover your roots. So I'm gonna start with the first one, which is the most obvious, to color your roots, dye them. So we are offering a hair color kit. It's curbside pickup. It is formulated specifically for your hair. So if you're an existing client, we would just formulate it and you pick it up. If you're not an existing client, what we've been doing is doing virtual consultations, and that's a mix of video, pictures. I've had people come by the salon and we kind of do it through the window on our phone, and we've kind of made it work. And if you've never had color done with me, I am suggesting a patch test, which is completely free. The person picks it up. They do it themselves 24 hours later. If there is no reaction, then we're, you know, to go ahead to purchase the hair color. So that's the first one. And that's obviously the best way. If you don't want to be as drastic and dye your own hair, which I commend those people who didn't as well and waiting for their stylist. So that's great. So the second way I'm going to talk about is a root concealer. It's a spray. it's kind of hard to tell, but it's they come in four different colors. They're by a company called Ref, and they are potato starch based. So what that means is that it's not water soluble. So you can go in the rain, you can actually go swimming with it, and it stays in until you actually shampoo it out. So that's a nice one because it's long lasting. It's not going to transfer on a lot of things. If you touch your hair, it's pretty safe to use. So that's the second way. The third way is a color mask. Now these are, they come in nine different colors, and they are not going to cover your roots, but they will help to diffuse the brightness of it, I would say, and also help to make the rest of it look, you know, better. So as long as everything else looks better, usually it makes the roots not be so noticeable if your hair is shiny and healthy looking. Another way is dry shampoo. Now, most people have been living off of dry shampoo. So if you have dark roots, so if you're a blonde or your hair is naturally darker than what you dye it, dry shampoo kind of has a powdery tone to it. So it diffuses the line as well. It's not going to cover it, but it will help to diffuse it. And they do make dry shampoo that's brown. So if you do have gray hair, purchase a dry shampoo that is colored. So that way you get two uses out of it. You can use it as a dry shampoo and also as a root concealer. Another one that I think is a fantastic, doesn't cost you any money because it's things you have already in your home. You can use your eyeshadow. Just pick a color that matches. You can also use brow gel or brow cream. And the brow one is very good for these little sideburns. So if you have some stubborn little grays here, you just take a little brow gel and put it right on, and it covers well. That obviously doesn't last as long as, let's say, a root spray, but it's good for a quick fix and inexpensive, and most people have it. So the next, the five remainder tips are going to be ways to disguise and camouflage. So they're not really a product, they're just little tips. So one of the first tips is to change your part. So most people have a lot of gray where they normally wear their part. So if you switch your part to a different area, most likely there's not as much gray on the other side. I think that has to do with some sort of environmental effect that it has on our hair. So most of the time, if we have a part, the sun is kind of doing its thing. And anyway, switch your part or a zigzag part. So a zigzag part is great. So you just take anything that's pointy, you could even use a pencil, and just start on one end and go back and forth. And what that'll do is create some texture, and you can't really see the part. So it kind of, you know, camouflages. I know now we're at like 2 months out, so most people's roots are probably longer than they would like. So that might not work as well if you have a lot of gray, but it's good if you just have a few or you're just starting to go gray. Another one is to put your hair in a ponytail and kind of wear like sort of a wet look. So if you put it up in a ponytail and you put hairspray or a little gel, darker hair will not be as noticeable with the gray. So that is a good tip. Another one are braids. I'm going to bring over my little friend here. So braids create texture in the hair. So no matter where you put the braid, whether you do in the front or you do two braids or just do like a regular, not a French braid, but just a regular braid and just kind of like pin it, that'll help to also kind of camouflage a little bit. It takes the eye away from the part. The braid kind of brings more attention to it as opposed to bringing attention to the braid, not to the part. And then also, as Terry said, headbands are great. We have a bunch. We have all different kinds. We have like these types. These are great also. So that'll help to hide a little bit. And then the last but not least is what we call faux bangs. So I don't think we probably have enough time for me to demonstrate it right now, but I am going to be posting a video tonight on social media doing a demo on that. And basically what that is we kind of, if we have a couple minutes, I'm not sure if we do or don't.
2 minutes.
Okay, 2 minutes. I'll do a really quick version. So what you do is you take half of your hair, you put it in a ponytail. And then you bring the bangs forward. So you take half that hair and you make bangs with it. And then you kind of pull them. These might be too many, but that's okay. We'll pin them back. You kind of get them to the length you want. You pin them in. And like I said, I'm going to be making a video that's a little bit more precise and give a little bit more detail. But this is a great way to get rid of the roots.
It's amazing.
So wait, and then you pull this down Yeah, this, I probably would get rid of this because it's too big, but anyhow. Then you take the back section of your hair, you do another ponytail, and with this one, you're gonna wrap it around and it'll create a top knot. And I'm not gonna make it precise, but you would pin this in and you'd have a little top knot and you'd have bangs and you can kind of wear them as a side bang and all while your roots are covered. And this is also a great one to put, I'm gonna let this go, it's probably gonna fall, but you put a headband over it.
That's amazing.
I know.
And you got cute little bangs and a little top knot.
That looks awesome.
Yeah, this I would get rid of.
Horrible.
You get the gist of what it would be if I had the time.
Yeah.
So there we go.
I feel like I have already learned so many things in the last hour.
So I was very impressed with the contour thing because I do use bronzer as contour. So I need to step into blend and get myself.
There you go.
Real contour.
Step into blend.
That was great, Claudia. Thank you so much.
Oh, you're welcome. I know I had to like speed through it because I don't want to hold everyone up.
That's awesome. Thank you.
That's a great trick.
Claudia, before you go, tell us how we find you on social media.
Sure. So I'm on Facebook and on Instagram, and it's Elegant Image Salon on both. If anybody needs to make any purchases, we do curbside, and you can either email us at eisalonwestfield@gmail.com. We also are taking phone orders too. So you could also reach us 908-232-4900.
Thank you. Hope to see you soon.
Thank you. Yes. I hope so. Thank you guys so much for doing this.
Yes.
Thank you.
Yes.
Bye.
Bye-bye. Thank you.
Thank you. That was amazing.
Well, I'm learning stuff too. Lots of stuff. I don't know how much of it I can use, but some, you know, I got a little gray here. Okay. So next we're going to bring up Anna. And Anna, forgive me if I mispronounce your last name. Mastroianni. I think maybe I got it. Mastroianni from Sole Shoes. Anna, are you with us today? You are. Appear on the screen.
On mute.
Maybe she's with us, but on mute.
One sec.
Can you hear me now?
Better?
Yes.
All right, excellent. How is everyone? I've enjoyed these presentations. They're incredible. What a town we have.
I know. How are you?
This is great. Thank you. This is for all of you. Salute. This is what we would normally be serving tonight. So cheers to all of you and to all of us and for hanging in there and doing our best.
Anna, we're not seeing you. We are hearing you, but we're not seeing
her.
I see her.
We want to
see you. Do?
Yeah, okay, I see her.
Okay, good.
Okay. So how is that? What would you like to know?
Tell us about your inventory, Anna. I walk by and I peer in all the time.
We've got such a huge collection of spring stuff, from comfort to really jazzy things, that I hope you'll be able to join with us later tonight. We are doing a live fashion show at 7:00, and we're highlighting, last week we did our spring summer collection, Tuesday we did our comfort shoes, and tonight we are doing our jazz, fantasy, va-va-voom, let's go out and party shoes. So we really would love for you to join us, and we'll also be giving away a free pair of shoes, so you'll wanna do that too. And we've been loving connecting with our customers in another way now, with a sort of a concierge service. And we do that anyway when you come in and we offer you a bunch of different shoes that you might not have thought of to try, but we know they're great. So we want you to have a peek at them. And so that's what's happening. People are calling and saying, I need this. And what do you suggest? So I then go and personal shop for you, which I love to do because we know our shoes and we know it works. And I send you pictures and then you get to choose and give me a little feedback. And within a couple of go arounds, we've found the exact right shoe for you. And it's been amazing. So we really enjoyed that experience. It's a whole nother way to bond.
And I've loved all your posts on Instagram.
Thank you.
Videos and your posts. It's been really fun. It really has been fun to shop and see your face because we miss seeing you.
Oh my gosh, I'm missing all of you. And for an Italian, this is torture. Not being able to hug my customers.
Yeah.
And kiss and give them all my love. It's really been intense, but we're making the best of it. And we have a huge collection, and you can look at it on our, we have over 300 pairs of shoes on our Facebook store, and that's Italian Sole, S-O-L-E. Also on our Instagram, you can shop right from there. And so we also have accessories too, and not just shoes. And we have shoes, we consider our customers family, and we're a family store. So that's how we think of the whole thing. We've got men, women's, kids, something for the whole family.
Anna, how long have you guys been in business now? I mean, I remember when you were in your other location and my kids stopped, we got my kids' shoes there when they were little. How long has it been?
It's been 18 years. And actually, come August 1st, it will be 19 years.
Oh.
Wow,
and does everybody know your little secret about the Sopranos? Come on.
Because I don't know.
My daughter watched the Sopranos for the first time, and I remember you had some of them at your very grand opening.
I did.
Come on, tell them your secret.
Thanks, Shelley. I love that secret. It was one of my favorite experiences in life working on Sopranos, because there too it was like family, and it was one of my first bigger jobs on doing stunts, and I loved it. And we had Vincent Pastore at opening. Right. We had Dan Aldi, and they're all my friends, so I love
them. I'm reliving it through my daughter, who's watching the series for the first time during this pandemic, and I was just talking about you because she's in the second season.
So. You know, somebody just asked me about that, and we happened to find on YouTube when I got hit by a car, and I was
by the car. You were the mom, right?
I was the mom's friend that she ran over in the driveway. Yeah. And every time I see that, it kind of cracks me up, but it was fun. So do you want me to show you anything? Or?
Yeah, show us some of your top, can you show us some of your top sellers, your most favorite things this spring that people are asking about?
Absolutely. I'm going to turn the computer down. Yeah. I'm going to walk with my iPhone, okay? So give me one second.
Yeah.
Okay. Can you see me?
Not yet.
Not yet? Hold on, okay. It says it cannot start. Somebody disabled it.
Oh, no.
Try it again.
Sorry, guys.
Try it again, Anna.
I'm starting. Ah, can you see me?
Oh, yeah.
We can see you.
Hey. All right. Okay, perfect. Actually, I'm going to swing you around to some of the fantasy shoes we're looking at tonight.
Oh, wow.
Yeah, right? There.
Oh, wow.
Can you still see? Oh, look at these. Now these, Shelly, these are starting to be one of our favorites, one of our best sellers. And
they look comfortable too. And wait, Anna, who makes those? It's that brand that I like, right?
Oh, you love Bueno. It's a new brand for us, Shelly, and they're from Spain and they're amazing. Actually, if you see, I'm wearing them myself.
Oh, they look great.
Yeah. And this is our Made in Italy table. Everything here is made in Italy. Oh. I know that. These are. This one's getting a lot of attention. This is like a Prada-esque.
Wow.
Wow.
Isn't that cool? So these are what you'll be seeing tonight. And these are what we're going to be giving away.
Oh, cute.
Aren't these cute? That's and you get to choose the color. And they're $99.95.
And that brand is so comfortable. I have a pair of them.
And you know what? Let me take your... you know Beauty Feel, right? Beauty Feel is like that...
Yeah.
This is like the luxury comfort brand. This is a little bit, little on the higher priced. This is the brand you love. This is Bueno.
Yes.
These are super comfortable. You can wear these anywhere. And these are doing really well. Look at how cute these are.
These are
adorable. Nice leathers. Cute little high tops.
Very cute.
Look at these are doing really well too with a little bow. Yeah. And these are doing well here.
You're right by the window. The window. I've been staring at those shoes that are facing out.
Which ones? These?
Yes.
Oh, okay. Let me show you those. I'm going to bring you to the front. Okay. I hope I'm not making you dizzy. Look at these.
Oh, shopping,
guys. They're so cute.
Yeah, those are cute.
These are made in Italy. Gorgeous and super comfortable too. This is one of our best sellers. We're almost out of these.
Yeah.
Because of that little sole.
You have this animal print or something too, right?
Oh my gosh, Linda, you know you're so good. These are them. these are them.
Yeah, they're
adorable. Can you see them? Mm-hmm. Yeah. Oh, and these songs. These are doing really well too.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Love it.
Great.
So then some color, you know.
It's so great to hear that despite the fact that no one can come in the store yet, that you're sold out of stuff. Sold out of some sizes and
It's really I'm very happy because you know we've got and we're so lucky, Linda, that we've got such amazing customers that are so loyal and good to us no matter what. So and they trust us to select things that are right for them, which is what we love to do. We don't like to just sell shoes. We want to sell you that right shoe that you're going to feel so good about for so long. As a matter of fact, somebody this morning was telling me that somebody was commenting on her shoes and she said, "You're not going to believe this. I bought these 15 years ago when I was over on the other side." And That's what we love. We love to have that when somebody feels really good about what they're wearing. And that's actually what we're selling. We're not really selling shoes. We're selling that confident feeling, that feeling happy with what you're wearing. And, you know, you just behave differently when you're comfortable and you know you look good. So that's really what we're selling.
Thank you, Anna. I can't wait to come to you again.
Okay, don't forget tonight, 7 o'clock, live, Facebook Live, Italian Soli.
All right.
Okay, see you there.
Next year, we'll celebrate your 20th anniversary together.
Yes.
Oh, yes.
Big time. Big party.
Thank you, Anna. Okay. Our next presenter this is going to be fun. You know that, I don't know if everyone's aware that you can now purchase your to-go cocktails and pick them up curbside and take them home and drink them. But you can't. It's now okay to do that. And to show us how, from our master mixologist, to show us how to make the quarantini perfectly apt-themed drink for these times is Tim Boyle from 16 Prospect Wine Bar and Bistro. So Tim,
how are you guys?
Take it away.
Thanks. What I've chosen to do for our quarantini is something called the Corpse Reviver 2. And the Corpse Reviver 2, back in the 1930s at the Savoy Hotel, was something they used to drink, like we would drink a Bloody Mary. And when you see what's in this, you can't believe they drank this in the morning. So we have 1 ounce of Opier gin, one ounce of Cointreau, one ounce of Lillet Blanc, one ounce of fresh lemon juice.
Thank goodness there's finally a mixer.
We're going to add some ice. Give it a good stir. Glass. And it's that simple. 4 ingredients.
What is this I have?
I'm sorry?
What is that? What is this one? Oh, wait, hold on. Can you see
it? Right?
So that's the Corpse Reviver 2.
Is that this one?
Yeah.
Oh, yep. I'm gonna pour it. Now I know what's in it. I'm a little scared.
What does this taste like? Like, is there a drink that's similar that people would know or might know?
Not really. It's kind of interesting because of the different ingredients in it. It's got a citrus flavor to it, but it's really unlike any other drink.
Awesome. And people can order this and pick it up to go from you, correct?
Yes. And what we'd like to do is from tonight until Saturday night, anyone who mentions Lady Night and orders one of these cocktails will take 10% off.
Awesome.
Wow. Fantastic.
It's delicious.
That's, What do you think?
It's delicious and also, you see, very dangerous.
Tim, is this what it looks
like? Is it 5 o'clock yet?
Yeah. Della, you're drinking yours. I am so jealous.
Ah, of course.
I have one here.
So, Tim, this is what it
looks like. We'll get one over to you.
Okay.
There has been, I have to say, there has been one alcohol during this whole time that has been head and shoulders more popular than any other. That's these two right here. We've gone through more of this than anything else in the entire bar.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Are you doing that curbside too, Tim?
Yes, we are. Yeah.
So, Tim, we got tons of it. When you have your curbside pickup for your cocktail, is this the container?
Yes. Yeah, that's what they come in.
Oh, fantastic.
Excellent.
Great.
Now, so how's everybody doing?
Good.
And we miss you very much, Tim. We certainly miss.
Yeah.
I really can't wait
to be back. Awesome that you did the piano night. Will you be doing that again?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, probably in a couple weeks.
And Tim, you know, we're talking about what the reopening is going to look like. And one of the considerations is the closing of the block in front of your place. So see that? You got a thumbs up from him.
Yeah, that would
enable you to expand.
Also serves two purposes, to increase business, but also to keep it as safe as possible.
Well, that's the idea, is to enable people to social distance. And I think for the restaurants with the liquor license, I think this has been particularly hard because it's harder to, a big chunk of your revenue, I'm sure, comes from liquor sales.
Yes.
So anything that we can do to help enable and facilitate that for a community, I think, that is desperately waiting for a bar to open.
Well, I can tell you, I don't know what other towns are like. I have to commend you guys on how much information we get, how helpful that information is. And as was said before, I really feel like the town is really with us. As horrible as this situation is, it would be even more horrible if I felt like the town didn't think about us. And I have the absolute opposite feeling.
Yeah, that's what we've heard from other businesses. And that's, I do think that's a very special Westfield phenomenon. I really do. And I think, from the business's perspective, I hope it helps you see that there is a light at the end of the tunnel, that when we get through this, that you're going to be warmly embraced. And I think people will feel even a greater commitment to making sure that you're successful. So, But Bob will be circling back on like reopening plans and what might work for you.
Yeah.
And that whole block. Good if we could spread out a bit.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
Exactly. Yeah. Tim,
thank you.
You're very welcome, Tim.
Wait, what's this called again, Tim?
It's called the Corpse Reviver 2.
Okay.
Thank you, Tim.
We might have to rename that, Tim. We might have to. it tastes a lot better than that name.
I'm going to call it.
Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Thanks, Tim.
That's great. Good. Best of luck to you, Tim. Good to see you.
Thanks.
So next, it is my great pleasure to bring in to our Girls Night and pre-party Ed Menapace from the Farmhouse Store. And I have to give a special shout out to Ed and his partner Bill Curtis, because it was actually their idea to do this. We got an email one day from Bill, I think. He said, hey, we can't do Girls Night Out this spring. Maybe we can do it in the fall. We're hoping we can do this actually in real life in the fall, not virtually. But why not try to see if we can do something online and have women invite their friends to Zoom parties at night and then do something during the afternoon to educate our residents and our customers and consumers. So with that being said, I'm going to turn the screen over to Ed. If Ed is here.
He'll be right there.
He'll be right there. Okay.
He's still doing his blending, contouring and highlighting.
Right. sip of the experience.
Hello.
There he is.
Oh, hello.
Hi.
How are you guys?
Good.
How are you?
Good, good. We're really good. We are doing a lot of virtual designing these days.
Wow.
Well, it seems like a lot of people want to be at home right now. So we, or don't have a choice. So we've been doing a lot of design work and it's been really terrific. People are letting us into their homes with their phones and it's been a little bit creative, but we're having a great time with it.
So how does that work? And like people literally are just taking you on like almost like Facebook Live tours or
well, let me give you an example. We're doing, right now it seems like everybody wants a sectional in their home. I don't know whether there's something kind of cozy and enveloping about a sectional right now. So what I'll ask them to do, and people are a little bit afraid to do it by themselves because there's a lot of questions that people have to ask. We were just working on one a few minutes ago here and I thought I would show it to you. So what we do is we ask them a whole lot of questions and then we come up with a room plan that looks like this. So we get the scale of the room first. We need to know what size the room is first. We need to know kind of some details like, are there stairs going in? Are there tight turns going around? Because if you have a tight turn, you're gonna have trouble getting that corner in. I wanna know where the windows are in there. Are there architectural details like a big fireplace in the middle of the room that we need to work with? Where's the TV? Do you use this room to watch TV or is it more for entertaining? And do you have any existing pieces? This client happened to have two really beautiful chairs that they wanted to keep. And they also had a rug that we wanted to work with too. We wanna know what the colors are on the walls and the floors. Do they have pets? Do they have kids? Do they eat in the room? I know I've been eating, Bill and I have been eating on our sofa a lot lately. It seems to be a nice thing to do. So anyway, so we do that. We start with that and then we can send some colors home or I'll even go by their home and drop off fabric samples in their mailbox so they can have it in their house and they can see how it's working. So this customer wanted some blue in the room. So we decided to go with a huge blue sectional in there. So we dropped off where we're actually going to drop off all of these blue fabrics to them tonight so they can choose one of those. And then they didn't know what to do as far as accents, as far as pillows and things like that. And that's where our team has been really terrific in helping people design their homes. So you can do fun, crazy fabrics on there and mix and match fabrics like these beautiful geometrics and these beautiful prints. They're just great. So we've been doing a lot of those and we've probably sold, I don't know, in the past 14 weeks, we've probably sold 24 sectionals to local Westfield Scotch Plains people. So it's so nice that we're able to help people out when they are really having to nest, you know, it's been really terrific.
That's amazing. So Ed, I also noticed on Instagram and others, I see you guys are posting things and I see people immediately commenting like, how much is the chair? And then I hear you say it's gone. Like, how is that? How are you guys managing that? And is that been an intentional shopping strategy for you?
Yeah, it's been kind of fun because we treat the farmhouse store like three different stores really. So we have the outlet over in Garland, right. Which, and Matt, right. Our outlet over there, he posts pictures of what he thinks people will like right now. And he's very competitive about it. He wants to get likes and he wants to get sales out of those. So he'll post a picture and we'll do curbside pickup there. So people will order right from him there. So he'll give me a picture. He'll send it, like he just sent me one for tomorrow's posts. And so we'll post that tomorrow morning when I get up. And then Sue, who runs downstairs, she's posting pictures for the gift shop every day, which we consider the second store. And then for the furniture store, it was, I don't know, I kind of wanted it to be a little more aspirational as opposed to selling. You know, we did a lot of those in the beginning of the quarantine. We did a lot of those design challenge questions that people were really into. And that was great fun. So we just want people, we like it when people participate because we've been doing this now. We're in our 14th year here at Farmhouse Store and we know the community. These are our friends and family. And to see them respond back on social media, it's just a little, I don't know, it just reminds us that they're out there, you know, we're all doing the best we can, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. Well, hopefully, you know, I got word that things will be, you know, at least starting by appointment, and then other things will be probably imminent. So fingers crossed, we'll get.
That's what we're hoping for. As a matter of fact, it's been so good. The furniture department's been so good the way we've been doing it, just with, you know, private clients and just one-on-one. We may keep the upstairs by appointment only for a while and just open the gift shop downstairs and keep the outlet opened, you know, for general public.
That's actually probably, you know what, that's probably really smart. And that's probably, I think people would be most concerned right these days about just health and well-being. And so it's a great way to get started.
Health and well-being, it gives us a chance to make sure that we're doing things safely and responsibly.
Right.
But it also gives them an opportunity to have a little bit more of an intimate experience. And when you're talking about designing things for your home, it's a lot more than just going in and, you know, into a big box store and pointing, I'll take that one. You know, we're doing things custom made for people's homes. So that intimacy is really going to be kind of nice. So we're going to try that out.
Important. Well, that's great. Well, thank you for being so resourceful and adaptive through all of this. I really think it's amazing to see the journey that so many businesses have been on in terms of, you know, how they've had.
Well, we can't wait to see you all back in again.
Yeah, we can't
either. Miss seeing you in. We know you're a regular here, and we miss seeing your face in here.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's making me happy just seeing the upstairs. It's like, oh
thanks.
Still there.
Yeah, I know, right? It's so cozy.
Well, Dawn, anytime you want. You guys have my phone number. I'll give you a little virtual
tour. I know, we'll just come and like,
tell you, wait till you see the downstairs too. Bill has been painting like crazy. The downstairs.
It looks amazing. I saw the pictures.
Looks really great. So.
Awesome. It's going to be like on a vacation. Like once we can all go out again, and it's like, who needs to go anywhere? It's going to be so great to just be able to visit all of our, you know, beloved stores. Because you're right. Tim was just on, and Anna was on, and Kira, it's like, we're so attached to the shop owners. You know, it's not just what you're selling. You know, we really just love to come in and see you guys.
Oh, Tim and Anna are so great too, aren't they?
Amazing.
Absolutely.
We're very lucky.
Yeah. All right, guys. Well, thank you so much
for coming here today.
And stay well. And hopefully we'll see you really
we'll see you soon.
Thank you again, Ed. And we hope to be in the store soon, really soon.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you.
Take care. Say hi to Bill.
Yes. Okay. We are going to pivot a little bit back to the food genre. And we're going to take a little short trip to Italy. Well, not to Italy, but, you know, to Broad Street, where Farinolio Cucina is. And we are going to bring on Lero Orlando from Farinolio Cucina, who's going to show us how to make a fresh bruschetta, which I know a lot of people really, really love. So,
hello.
Are you there? There you are.
Yes, I am. I sure am. Hello. How are you?
We're great.
Very good. Can you hear me well?
Very much.
Okay, perfecto. So first of all, thank you all for giving me the opportunity to present a little bit more Farinolio Cucina and the amazing project that the owners of Farinolio, Francesco, Annette, and Antonino, came up with. So Farinolio Cucina started a few months ago, and unfortunately, we picked the wrong time, because as soon as we started organizing all of these beautiful Italian events, then we were forced to postpone all of it because of the coronavirus. But this didn't stop us at all. And we started to do online cooking classes, especially on Instagram. And we started doing our cooperation with all of the chefs that we work with that live in Italy. And what we do it live on Instagram, on Facebook, on Zoom. So this is the way it started. Hopefully when we start opening soon, we will continue with our Italian cooking program at Farinolio, at the James Ward Mansion that we work with, and at people's houses as well. So that's the goal. So in the meantime, today, I want to show you how to prepare a very simple antipasto. So here I have all of the ingredients. We have a very simple bruschetta. And bruschetta actually comes from the word bruscare. And bruscare, it's a Tuscan word and literally means to grill the bread. So here you start with some toasted bread over here that are already toasted. And then you can use any kind of toppings you like better, of course. But today I want to do a Tuscan version, a versione Toscana. Since all of the owners at Farinoglio are from Tuscany, I want to keep it that way. Un tema Toscano. So here we have, like you can see, we have fagioli cannellini. Cannellini beans that I soak them into water for a few hours, and then I cook them for about 45 minutes or so. And I didn't season them yet. So it's just plain boiled cannellini beans. Then here we have pomodorini ciliegina. So here we have cherry tomatoes that I just cut them in half. E qui abbiamo le olive nere, so black olives. So of course, to prepare bruschetta, you can use any kind of ingredients you like better. This is just a simple way to prepare a simple antipasto. So I will start with some of our ciabatta, and ciabatta bread is something that Tonino, our master baker at Farinoglio, makes it all the time. It's one of my favorite bread there because it's super crunchy and it's perfect for bruschetta. You can also use a baguette. And then the first step, I'm going to brush on top some garlic. And it's not regular garlic. I don't know if you can see it from there, Shelly, but this is a black garlic. So it has a sweeter flavor than a regular garlic. So I will just put some on top of it.
Where do you get that black garlic? Is it in the grocery store?
Black garlic, it's not that easy to find it actually, but fortunately we have our supplier, Baldur, who is connected to all of the different producers and farms all over the States and also all over Europe. So I was able to find it in Slovenia, and I decided to get it for Farinoglio because it really makes a huge difference. If you don't have black garlic at home, it's okay. You could also use regular garlic, or you could also use some red onion or shallots, and then you can incorporate it to the tomatoes, basically. So then the next step, I will start seasoning my ingredients. So in Italy, we love playing with different fresh herbs. My small garden, and I'm going to use a different kind of fresh herbs to play with. So you can use oregano. And I always recommend to just use your hands. So do not use a food processor or a knife because the blade would ruin the leaf. So un po' di oregano, a little bit of oregano, and you put it in the cannellini beans. And with your hands, you just break it into small pieces. Then you could also use some menta fresca, fresh mint. But again, feel free to play with the ingredients you have at home or in the garden. That fresh thyme would be great as well. Here you also have some basilico fresco, fresh basil. You could also use lemon verbena. You could use some lemon zest, orange zest. Instead of spreading the garlic on top of the bruschetta, you could also do some ricotta cheese. So there's no limit to your imagination. So here we have the cannellini beans with the fresh herbs. Now I'm going to put in there also the black olives. Next step, a few pomodorini, a few cherry tomatoes.
Oh my gosh, my stomach's growling.
And it's so easy to prepare. This is perfect for a nice happy hour with some friends. You just need a crunchy bread and some fresh ingredients, and that's all. The party is ready to start. Then here I am going to use some sea salt that I just sprinkle it on top. Of course, you could also use some black pepper, hot pepper, whatever you like better. Poi usiamo l'olio extravergine. So this is extra virgin olive oil from Farinoglio. This one comes from Tuscany, from San Casciano. It's actually very interesting because it's made with three different varieties of olives from that area. And it has a very intense flavor. So especially when you prepare something like this, you really want to taste and smell the aroma of the olives. So this one is the perfect example. So now we just mix all of the ingredients. See how beautiful it is, all the colors, the fresh herbs, the green and the cherry tomatoes and the cannellini beans, the olives. So you just mix it well. And then you have your pane bruschettato, so the toasted bread. I'm going to show you in a second because I realized that it's kind of low, the table. So adesso vi faccio vedere, I'm going to show you. You place your ingredients, your toppings right on top of your bread. If you want, you could also add some more tomatoes or olives or salt or olive, whatever you prefer. And basically your bruschetta is ready. See how simple but beautiful it is?
Wow.
Grazie.
Mouth watering.
Yes, exactly. It looks fantastic.
I might try and make that.
So this is basically what we're planning to do at Farinolio Cucina. Farinolio started with a vegan. They're all from Tuscany and they all want to share their Tuscan recipes and their Tuscan knowledge and heritage. Yeah. Together with me, we decided to come up with the idea of Farinolio Cucina. So why don't we expand the idea of the Tuscan specialties and we talk about all of the specialties all over Italy. So it's gonna be a regional program. So now we just look forward to open up again and meet all of our beautiful customers.
Well, that's terrific, Lara. We can't wait till you open up again. Are you doing curbside pickup now and delivery?
Yes, so in last month or so, we started curbside pickup and delivery service as well. And we also started adding more fresh meals to go. So now besides all of the beautiful panini with our schiacciata, that is, we also provide with lasagna, we prepare Tuscan specialties, different kind of seasonal soups. So for example, today I prepare a beautiful soup with zucchini, asparagus, and fresh herbs. So everything is on our website, on farinolio.com.
That's great, delicious. We just had new neighbors move in on our street. And so we figured the best way to welcome them to Westfield was to take them lunch from Farinolio. They loved it.
That's great, thank you so much. I really appreciate it.
And I've had lunch with Farinolio as well, and I couldn't agree more.
Grazie. No, Farinolio could be addicting.
I can't wait to get back there.
Grazie mille.
Grazie a voi. It's been a pleasure.
Thank you so, so much.
My pleasure. Grazie. Ciao a tutti.
Ciao.
Thank you.
Ciao. So we're now going to pivot back kind of little creative stuff, kind of food-ish. So Miriam Silver-Verga and Hillary Kaplan from Mimi and Hill Design Studio are here and they are going to show us how to make a photo-worthy cheese board. This is something that is right up my alley because I love cheese. Mm-hmm. Let's take it away.
Hi, everybody. Nice to see you.
Cheers.
We're so glad to be together. We were apart a long, long time. It was terrible for us, but we're thrilled to be here, thrilled to be with you. Thank you so much, Bob and Nikki and the Downtown Westfield Corps. Your presence during this last few months has been like a great big giant hug, and we are so appreciative. We have the best downtown in the world, and that's a large part, we think, to our mayor and our councilwomen who work so hard, tirelessly, and for free, which is just the craziest thing. So thank you, thank you, thank you. We're excited to be here. We're actually in my new kitchen, yes, which was fortunately just completed right before this.
I've been following your progress.
Yeah,
I want you to know, I just changed my background to my office in your honor because these are the ladies that did my office in town hall. So, it's one of the reasons I actually love going there is because how they transformed it. So very grateful for your imagination and creativity and your generosity. So
you inspired.
I'm thrilled that you're here today. Your kitchen looks amazing.
Oh, yeah. Thank you.
And the
you.
Living room, but
yeah, you can see a little of both. But no, we're so thrilled. We brought a little bit of our shop. We're located downtown on Elmer Street, 227 Elmer Street, in a shop. We've been there 3 years already. We can't believe
crazy.
It.
Yeah,
it's nuts. So we brought a lot of our shop home with us. We pivoted in the heels of quarantine, and our shop is now online, which is very exciting. We've been dying to do that, never sort of had that push.
There you go.
So we're really excited that we got so much online. And we want to make sure to sort of present here what's happening. We're good. Okay, so sorry, you guys went blank. But
yeah,
we're still here, so that's good.
Okay.
So Hillary's going to present how she makes a cheese board, because as you know, everything Hillary touches always looks so beautiful. I always joke I'm her assistant. She doesn't like it when I say that, but she really has just the most beautiful taste.
In our shop, we have a lot of things that are gift giving. So we figured when you're gift giving, and right now in quarantine, we've been doing a lot of cheese platters and charcuterie trays for ourselves. This is one that's kind of done up already. And our key thing about doing a tray like this, and we know it's food and you're going to eat it, but we love it to look beautiful. So we balance off color and texture and high and low. So I'm going to start building it. We already have some cheeses on here.
Your cheeses are your hero of your cheese board. So really they should be the first thing you place and kind of place them around the board. Of course, we didn't put the yellow cheese beside the yellow cheese. Mm-hmm. We put the white in the middle. We try to play, like Hillary said, getting a little bit of color and texture and contrast against the board. We love these black mango boards. They've been flying out of the shop. So I don't even know how many we have left right now, but we are getting more. And we sort of fill in on the cheese board with some of the meats and cover that up. You know, over here, there's like a fun way you could fold your meats, which we did when we tucked them in over here. You fold them in half and kind of quarter them. Hillary's just laying them out on a semicircle right now.
Like we said, we like to do heights. So we sell these little honey jars in our shop, but you can also we have fig jam in here. So we would put this on one area. And then we have little dishes like this. And for instance, we might fill it with our almonds like this. And then we kind of give the height over here. Again, just constantly building and filling in all the spaces.
You don't have to put those in jars all the time. You can kind of fill in little spots with it tumbling over to give that feeling of excess, which is really what these cheese boards are about.
And abundance.
Abundance and excess. We loved listening to Laura. She reminded us of our trip we made to Italy 10 years ago already. When we had new babies, crazy. We just up and left them. I can't believe it. We were so smart back then.
Now we're stuck with them forever, it feels like. Oh, love them. So anyway, we're keeping on building on this. These are great. These are kind of like pickled vegetables that you can kind of layer in here, and they have a great color to them. We put them over there. So again, layering.
I am right now obsessed with anything pickled. I don't know where that's coming from all the way, but I'm just following it. So really loving anything pickled right now. I think that must be my father's Polish German roots are coming out strongly. So she has a little space over here. She's going to fill the corners.
Got here some more crackers.
I want to know why you both look so great. Your hair looks great. Like, really? Like, how do you look so good in quarantine? How do you get...
We do have the mentality when you put a pretty blouse on, you feel good. We've been working in our office, which is in back of our shop, because we have an interior design business as well. And
we do Zoom calls all day and we put on pretty blouses. It just makes us feel good. I don't know.
But sometimes we don't have pretty blouses on, and that's true also.
you don't see what's going on down there right now. So.
She looks cute.
Yeah, exactly. She
always does. You know, Hillary.
I'm sure.
You guys are going to have to make sure to push that a little closer to us too, so that we can see it.
So we'll bring it in.
Final creation there.
So when we said we were going to do this tray, we also reached out to Nosvinos, and they picked two wines to pair with us.
Oh,
they have a white wine and a red wine, and we've had it on our posts and stuff. So Miriam and I are trying this kind of organic white wine with this tray, and it has like a nice. Yum. Mineral effervescence kind of in it, and it's so yummy. So here you see, this is kind of how you layer. The great thing about these trays is Miriam always says, it's like a meal, because what you're doing is you're putting, you know, a little protein, a little carb, a little meat, a little fruit, a little vegetable.
And it feels so special to our kids when we put these out. It just feels like it's an event and a party, even if it's just our family. Right. But that said, Hillary has three kids. I have four kids. So just our family
is a party.
So.
Right.
We haven't boredom creep into our time. So these are also, these little bowls are great to put out for when you have olives, just like a gentle place to catch pits for people so that, you know, they're not in that awkward moment of what do I do with my pits? And then
we have, these are just some of the stuff we have in our shop. So we have tons of different cheese cutters, you know, for different types of cheese, soft cheese, hard cheese, you need all different kind of cutters.
I feel like you can never have enough of these. Like, I love them, and they have these different marble handles. We're really loving marble these days.
And this is a massive tray that we carry, but we also do some smaller trays because you're not always having, sometimes it's just you and your husband or a friend. So we have smaller trays, round, rectangular, marble. You know, it seems to be the trend. So we happen to carry a lot of them in our shop.
But you saw how quick that was to put that together. And it just feels so festive and so welcoming and a great way for your family to feel like they're having a special night, even if it's just you guys at home. Oh, put some of the basil on it.
Yeah.
These have been flying off our shelves. They're little herb pots,
yeah,
but they self water, which is good because we're not always, the best water. So these are hydroponic herb pots that have been doing really well for us in our shop.
We have them with cilantro. Sorry, go on.
Before we move on to the next presenter, can you tell us a little bit about your new website for your shop, I believe?
Yes, it is. www.mimiandhillshop.com, different from our other website, which is mimiandhill.com, that has our work on it and our portfolio. We've been designing together for 10 years, so we have a pretty abundant portfolio at this point. Our Instagram also shows our most recent work, which is at mimiandhill. We would love it if you followed us. That's one thing we can do for any of the small business owners who are coming on. Leaving positive reviews on their sites if you've had a chance to go into their shops or following them or mentioning them. These are all little ways we can all be supporting each other from home, even if we can't be at the shops. Our shop does do local drop-off and delivery. We do curbside pickup. We also have started shipping, which is crazy. We had clients reaching out to us from Nevada asking for our product. So we started shipping.
And we gift wrap. Cool. And Miriam's daughter, Tessa, works for us. And she'll gift wrap and drop it right off at your door, which is a great way to feel special.
Awesome.
So, sounds like Father's Day and wedding gift ideas.
We'll throw a little Father's Day section onto our website. Probably at the rate we've been doing it lately, could be up by tonight.
We do have a girls night in little section in our website. So all these items are there if you want to purchase, and they could be delivered tomorrow.
Well, it looks beautiful. Absolutely beautiful.
Thank you.
So good to see you.
Cheers, guys. Happy girls' night in, ladies, and the few gentlemen who are out there. We're sure you're there.
Cheers.
Thank you so much.
You're here.
Great seeing everybody.
Hey, good to see you
too. Thank you.
See you in the store soon. All right. We're they talked about pairings, I think. And that's actually another perfect segue to our next presenter, who is Jeff Dola from Adam's Tavern from the Harvest Group. And Jeff is gonna talk to us about, or show us, I hope, about some really cool, sweet summer pairings. I think with sangria, Jeff, if I'm not mistaken.
Yes, it is.
All right, so Jeff, take it away.
Hello, everybody. Happy Ladies Night in. Thank you for joining us at Adam's Tavern. I just want to thank the Downtown Westfield Corporation. I want to thank the mayor's office. I want to thank the entire town for all of your support throughout all of this. It's been incredible. And Westfield is just an incredibly heartwarming place to be. So last year, I remember Girls Night Out, and it was a rosé sangria night. So we decided to bring it all back for you. And tonight, we were doing a combination between our rosé sangria, which you can now get in these great little 16-ounce jars, as well as this vegetable spread. And here you'll see hummus with some sunflower seeds, some eggplant campanada, some beets, some arugula and feta. And we made these very healthy and fun homemade sunflower crisps. And we just think it's a great time of year to start thinking about sitting out back on your patios, enjoying the warm weather. Now that Memorial Day has come and gone, enjoying your family outside. And what better way to do that than light bites and a little bit of rosé sangria. I love that last video talking about the charcuterie board, the cheese and meats, also a perfect thing to do this time of year. Sit out back by the pool or on your patio and enjoy it. So today we're gonna teach you actually how to make our rosé sangria, which we want you to be able to do from home. So of course, the start of any rosé sangria is this wonderful wine, rosé wine. You can use whatever wine you want, as long as it's of the rosé variety. But the start to every sangria is going to have these three ingredients. I'm giving you some inside information here. You got brandy, that's going to be in every sangria. You have triple sec, which is a brandy. It's an orange brandy. We know it for its use in the Cosmo. And then we add some sort of flavored vodka to it. So with the rosé sangria, we like to add our peach vodka. If you're doing red sangria, you can add strawberry, raspberry vodka. And if you're doing white sangria, you can use lemon vodka. So you can switch it around. So using triple sec, using brandy, flavored vodka, those three are going to be the big ones.
Girls' Night In.
Flying over the top.
On video for the town of Westfield.
Then you're going to do lemon juice.
Oh my gosh, the whole process. So, you might have started after you and Mari left Westfield, but
yes,
everyone's going to do some strawberry simple syrup.
Girls Night Out, so
can you hear me right now? I think I might be.
Wait, on 1 second.
You come from,
we need someone to mute.
You know,
someone needs to mute.
The shops downtown, but of course, no one.
Okay.
All right, so we were making the sangria. You use the brandy, you use the triple sec, and you use the flavor vodka. Now, to add to that, you add the rosé wine, and then to add to that, you're going to use a combination of citrus and a combination of sweet. With all cocktails, you're constantly trying to balance citrus and sweet. So we're going to use lemon juice as our citrus, freshly squeezed lemon juice, just a little bit here for you to see. And then we actually make our own simple syrup. And simple syrup is basically sugar water. It's one of the best ingredients behind any bar. And we change the simple syrup depending on the type of sangria we're doing. So this is gonna be a strawberry simple syrup to go in our rosé sangria. When you're making simple syrup, grab a pot, go to the stove, and then do equal parts water and sugar. So a cup of water and a cup of sugar. Bring it all to a simmer, and then throw in whatever you want the simple syrup to taste like. If you'd like it to be strawberry, or mint simple syrup, bring it to a simmer and then throw those ingredients in and let them simmer for a couple minutes. Then take them off and cover them with some sort of top and let them steep like a tea. Then you'll strain it out and you'll see that you have this really beautiful colored simple syrup, which is gonna add a little bit of flavor and complexity. And that simple syrup and the lemon juice are gonna balance each other out really well. My two secret ingredients, you have this wonderful item here, apple juice. Apple juice is a great ingredient with any sangria. And then right before we put it all in the glass, we add a little bit of pineapple juice. And that's going to give you a frothiness, which is just a nice little trick when you're actually making the sangria. And when you shake it, you're going to wind up getting a froth. So Here I've got a shaker. I just put some of the rosé sangria in. I'm gonna serve it in this beautiful wine glass. Get a little shake. And then you'll see as it's pouring here that it's nice and frothy. And that's kind of the pineapple juice doing its work. So that's how you do the sangria. It's always fun for any backyard party. You can build it in one of those big jugs, and it's perfect time of year for it. So give us a call, try the sangria, try your vegetable spread, and we really miss you over here. And can't forget these, some diced strawberries that we like to add to it.
So Jeff, that that pairing that you, the rosé sangria with the little appetizer, how long is that on the menu for takeout?
So we're gonna do that all through this weekend. So give us a call all the way up until Sunday, and then you can come in and get the pairing. And for $25, you get the sangria as well as the appetizer, and that saves you,
I think
it's like $10 off for the combo package. So give us a call.
Oh, wow, that looked great.
It looked great.
The apple juice, a little secret. I would have guessed.
Yeah, apple juice is a really good secret. Yeah, it's a good item. For sure. I mean, it's you always get a little apple with your wine or some fruit of that sort, so it works very well.
Right.
And Jeff, you're open for curbside pickup and delivery currently, right?
So we haven't really been doing delivery. We've been doing more curbside pickup due to the great demand from the town. We are open for pickup, and we do deliveries depending on our level of business when we can. You can find our menus on adamstavern.com, and you will see a cocktail menu on there and a wine list menu as well. So we just started a full cocktail menu. We've got 7 cocktails on there. And we also have cocktail kits, which we've been having a lot of fun with and the town's really been enjoying. So you can get a Cosmo kit or a Moscow Mule kit, and we'll give you the full bottle of vodka and all the ingredients and a recipe, and you can go home and make it with your friends and family. We do also want
those are
to
great.
Let everyone know.
Those are great kits.
Thank
those
you.
I gave some of those cocktail kits. They're great gifts to drop off for people, the cocktail kits.
Yeah, we appreciate that. We have been getting a lot of gifts. On Mother's Day, a lot of kits were dropped off to mothers, and Father's Day, too, it's a perfect gift. We have an old-fashioned kit and a Manhattan kit on the menu. So those
go. That's great. That's a great idea.
Yeah, those would be good for the fathers.
Absolutely.
And we're starting brunch this Sunday. Definitely something that I've been missing. So Sunday from 12 to 3, you'll be able to get some fun brunch items, a ham, egg, and cheese, a French toast, and some other things. So check out the website on that regard.
We will. And hopefully, Jeff will be able to get you open soon, at least partially, you know, for partial seating. It won't be full seating, certainly up front, but you know, we'll do the best we can with whatever the governor allows us to do during these times to allow more people to enjoy your great food and your great drinks.
Yeah, we really appreciate it. You know, slow and steady wins the race. My girlfriend's an ER nurse in Morristown, so just seeing everything that the town's been doing with the local hospitals and everything, I really appreciate it. We've already redesigned all of our dining rooms to have smaller seatings and making sure the tables are all separated, and we're ready to go. So we're excited for the green light from the governor's office and looking forward to working with you on the reopening and everyone else in town. So it's just, Westfield has been extraordinary as a town, watching how you all come together, and even events like this, I'm blown away.
Well, thank you, Jeff. Thank you so
thank
much.
Thank you. Can't wait to see you.
Can't wait.
I mean, I know I miss you all. And I do also want to let you know that our sister restaurant, Huntley, did just open as well. So if you're a fan of Huntley, give them a call.
Excellent. Thank you.
I'm a big fan of the whole Harvest Group.
Yes.
Exactly.
Class act.
We'll be back, definitely. So we'll be back in. Thank you, Jeff.
My pleasure.
And now it's my pleasure to bring in an architect, but he's not your traditional kind of architect. He's a hair architect. Dan Schopp from Dan T. Hair Architects is our next presenter. And Dan is actually someone I spoke to, one of the first people I spoke to when I started here. And I believe Dan just recently opened his shop, his salon, and then COVID happened. So he is someone as well who I'm really hoping to get open sooner rather than later. And hopefully that will be very soon in June. But right now I'd like to bring up Dan.
I'm still muted, Dan.
Okay.
There you go.
How was that? Good?
Good.
All right. Hello, hello. How are you, Bob?
I'm fine.
Mayor Shelley. Councilwoman Dawn, I've spoken to you and Nikki. And Nikki, also, it's a pleasure to see you in person, in virtual person. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to... thank you so much for having me as kind of the new guy on the block, you know, present and help out and give a little bit of a different perspective. It's so wonderful to see the relationships that were formed over years of these wonderful restaurants and salons and clothing stores. And it's just great to see what a community we have. It's an unusual way for me to get to know you all. But it's a pleasure to see your hearts. And thank you for caring about people who could have just opened and then all of a sudden suddenly been closed. So we really appreciate that. Thanks. So I wanted to share a few things with you since we're not doing it from the salon right now. My heart had gone out to think about those who were in a situation where they can't go to a salon, they might not be able to have any type of real salon access products. And I went into some of the local pharmacies and found some things that I think are gonna be helpful to get you through. I saw also before that we had, I believe it was Linda was on also, and a number of people have needs with their hair, especially the roots. I want to encourage you as somebody who's done this for probably about 25 years and has done it internationally. I'm thankful to be in town and open our first salon studio in Westfield. It's such a wonderful place. And they really have an international, you know, awareness of quality on every level. So this is something that's kind of a quick fix. I wanted to share this with you ladies. It's more for the ladies today. That there are ways to touch up your roots where you don't have to actually use anything that is permanent or semi-permanent. And I wanted to share this first of all. I found a few things in the store, and this is just for the ladies to kind of get you through the next few weeks until we do open. One of them I found is a Clairol root touch up. Okay, now the way that this works, I'll just share it with you real quick. These are things that you find in CVS. They're things you can find in Barron's. They're things that you can find in Walgreens. And what's nice about this is it's like a powder. Okay, so similar like you would use a powder and a brush, you would also use a powder on a brush and just focus on the hairline. Okay, so for ladies, it's really shampoo in, shampoo out. You can get them in blonde. You can get them in light brown, brunettes, medium brown, dark brown hair color. But these are wonderful things that do not cause such a corrective color. Because a lot of people who will be doing this on their own, going to the store and trying to buy something from the aisle, are going to be in for a big surprise. You know, those colors are very hard to correct. They take a few times. They're going to damage your hair. But things like this are going to be very, very easy to do. Here's another one by L'Oreal called Magic Root Precision. Okay. Again, these are not things that the salon carries, but these are things that you can find that are harmless. Okay. And they also do a good job. This is actually a medium brown. Okay. We had the makeup artist before, which I found, you know, wonderful. You could actually use even a brow pencil at times in your touch up. Okay. But this happens to be a Magic Root Precision pen. Okay. And what it does is you actually turn it clockwise. Okay. And then what it does is it dispenses, it powder gel to the bristles on top. And again, you paint it on. So similar as you would do a painting of some sort, you can go ahead and you can actually paint it on the areas almost like highlights. You don't have to have 100% coverage. But the good thing is at the end of the day, you're able to just shampoo it right out. And that's a wonderful thing. So I'm picking things that are a little bit more temporary fixes, but these are for the ladies at home that might not be able to know what color do we choose at home, you know, in our aisle, in a CVS or a Walgreens. You're talking about picking from, you know, maybe 50 different colors, and they're all temporary colors and they're not very professional, those colors. So I would rather, you know, see you even with a brow stylist boost and set. Here's another one where one side is actually a brush and on the other side is the actual color. Okay, so it's almost like a pen or a pencil, and then you brush it on. And if you have you just focus on the hairline. You just focus on your parting. And if you can do that, you can kind of get through, you know, a virtual event. You can get through a business event. You can get through a council meeting. A lot of times you can get through things until your stylist can get to you. And we also have one of these, a brow fast sculpt by Maybelline. They make them, L'Oreal makes them, Clairol makes them, Revlon makes them. And they're, again, it's all brush on. So just like you would do your brow, you could also do your hairline. And that will help you. You match it with a blonde, you match it with a brunette, and you're able to kind of really see yourself get through some important events. You can also use, very quickly here, you have ceramic round brushes, okay, with a dryer. Ceramic round brushes are wonderful for shine. They defrizz your hair. You use them with a dryer. And a little bit of mousse. A little bit of mousse helps every woman, you know, receive a little bit more body, a little bit more flexibility and volume to their hair. It adds texture. So things like this are very, you know, they're quick fixes, but they make you presentable for today's, you know, quarantine situation that we're all experiencing. And it's wonderful to be here with everybody. One of the other things that I wanted to share with you was that a lot of people are going through dry hair at this time. So during that time period, you could also use something that you'd find. One of the good products out there is like a lavender mint moisturizing shampoo and conditioner. This one happens to be by Tea Tree. You know, things like that help you through a season where you might not be able to have your stylist give you the proper scalp treatment or the proper hair treatment at this time. And then when we do have a chance to open, you know, we want to invite you over to the salon. We will be having some wonderful specials that will happen as a part of this, you know, pandemic. And I think what we're going to do is probably present women with what I call a 50-50 special, which is kind of any service will be 50. Okay, just to help you with that initial introduction back into your image. We specialize in precision image, haircuts and colors. It's something that we really, those consultations are always complimentary. And we wanna just see you really step into a beautiful new image. The good thing about freshly opening the Dan T. Hair Architect Salon is that you might have trouble getting to another salon that might have been more established because you are maybe on a waiting list. Well, we'll be sure to be able to prioritize you at Dan T. Hair Architects. You can take a look at us on the website. The website will be up in June, but we do have a Facebook page, Dan T. Hair Architects, and also Instagram. At Dan T1. So it's a pleasure to be here. And thank you again, Mr. Bob Zuckerman and Mayor Shelley. It's a pleasure and a privilege to meet you too here today.
Thank you so much for being here.
Yeah, it's wonderful to be a part of a community that cares as much of the person who's been here for 20 years as 2 months, you know? But the good thing is that, you know, we've been in hair internationally for probably 20, 25 years. So we really look forward to bringing that, you know, that experience and that trend-setting looks and helping the community really feel their best image-wise. It will be tough sometimes coming out, but the good thing is that when you're coming out of quarantine, you really get a look at yourself differently right now. You get to see more roots than you've ever seen, and maybe it'll also, you know, present an idea to you like, wow, maybe it is time for a change, you know, with all me seeing myself grown in my hair and noticing that my color looks a lot different. Maybe I should try a different color. Maybe I should try a different cut at this time. And, you know, we'd like to be that new option for you in town. And it's our pleasure to be here. And it might be just timely to have a wonderful way to get to know you all on the board and a wonderful new people working with downtown Westfield that I've had the privilege to talk with and also noticed a genuine concern for people who we don't even know each other hardly yet, you know, and I'm so impressed that it's more about community in Westfield. And it's been a privilege. So I will extend myself with tremendous to come out, and we'll, you know, when you come out of that quarantine, you're gonna need your image done. And we wanna be there for you with specials. We don't know what people have gone through, but we wanna be the people to do those specials for you and help you back on your feet also as we help each other. So thank you very much.
Very welcome, Dan.
Thank you so much.
Welcome to town, and we can't wait till you open. Thank you very much. Bye. Now we are going to bring Stevie back from Janice's Closet. And she's going to tell us who the winner is.
Wait, who is it again? Jan, who's the winner again? Nancy. Wait.
Pause.
Hi, guys.
Hi.
Can you hear me?
Yes, we can.
I'm so excited to see people. And I'm so excited to tell everyone who won. It's Nancy Remick.
Nancy Remick, awesome.
I know, how exciting. Look at it, isn't it beautiful?
That lucky Nancy.
I know, thank you so much for donating and supporting Westfield. We appreciate all of you.
Thank you very much. Thank you so much.
Thanks. I'm so happy that, I know I agree with what, of course I forget his name because I'm on the spot, but what the last person said, what everybody's been through and what everybody, it's very nice. I hope, I can't even talk. I can't wait to see everybody again. I think that's what I'm getting at.
Thank you so much.
We can't wait.
Thank you.
Yeah, God bless you.
I'm blubbering over here.
Congratulations, Nancy.
Congratulations, Nancy.
Yes.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Beautiful
man. Beautiful.
Right. Thank you again.
Of course.
I am now going to announce the winners of the gift cards, because we had another promotion going on with Girls Night In, and we asked people to send in receipts of items that they have bought over the last 10 days, and we would choose 10 people at random to win gift cards. So I'm going to announce those winners here. Michelle Sager has won a gift card to Elegant Image Salon, which is great. Melissa Manson has won a gift card to the French Martini. Allie Sacher has a gift card to Chipotle. So that's great, Allie. Laura Skidmore, Patricia and Paul gift card. So congratulations, Laura. Gail Malin, I'm not sure how it's pronounced. Inspiration Roll gift card. Congratulations, Gail. Francesca Azara has won a gift card to Jack Rabbit in Westfield. So that's wonderful. Carly McDevitt has also won a gift card to Chipotle. And Sylvia Correa has won a gift card to Elegant Image Salon. So congratulations to all the winners. Hopefully a lot of you are on the pre-party right now. And if you're not, we will get in touch with you and get you your gift card. So we have one more presentation before our grand finale. And that is, I'd like to bring in one of our downtown Westfield newest board members and longtime merchant in Westfield, Lillian from the Thai Lounge.
Hello.
Hi, Lillian. And I think, hopefully we have Gwen back. Gwen Trent, who we had on earlier today. And Lillian is supposed to be showing Gwen how to do some sushi rolls, right?
Yes, we are. You guys can hear me, right?
Yes.
Okay, great. So, hello, everyone. I wanted to also echoing all of the merchants, just thank downtown Westfield. I want to thank you, Bob. Thank you, Mayor Shelley, and also Nikki. You guys have worked so hard on this event, and you know, we can't thank you enough for making this for giving all of us an opportunity to showcase what we do here. We really feel supported, and I can't tell you how grateful I am. So anyways, but I what I wanted to show everyone today is our DIY sushi kit from the Kai Lounge. So what we have here is basically a little kit that allows you to basically make three rolls at home. And I think there's Gwen. Hi, Gwen.
Do you see me?
I see you now.
Okay. Wait, you have to turn up the sound.
Okay, no problem. So while you're doing that, I'll talk through my kit really quick. So in this kit, you basically get enough to make about three rolls. And what we have here, when you get a kit, it looks like this. There's a little one pager that kind of gives you some basic instructions. There are video instructions that's available through our Instagram account, Akai Lounge or Akai 2_Lounge. We have two restaurants and two Instagram sites. And they're step-by-step videos so that you can, they're step-by-step videos so you can see how to use this kit. So I'm gonna quickly go through what's in this kit, and I'm going to show you how to make a California roll, which is probably the most basic of all the rolls out there.
Hey, Lillian, there's a lot of background noise on your audio. If you could just do a sound check, thank you.
Oh, sure. Can you guys hear? Is this still a background noise badly? Hello?
Yeah, you have people in the restaurant, I guess, right? So.
Yeah, and I'm using a headset, which is strange. Hold on a second. So why don't I do this? Let me mute as I go through the roll so that way you guys don't hear the background noise.
Mute herself.
Okay, sorry, technical difficulties. Okay, so I'm going to, is this better now?
I think so.
Okay, awesome. So I have some rice here, and what I'm going to do is put on the seaweed, and I don't know if you guys can see. Let me just try to change this a little more. Okay, so to make a California roll, we first have to spread out the rice on some seaweed. Okay, so I've got the rice a little bit even. Are you guys able to see or not really?
I can see you.
Can see me, okay. We will figure out something. Let me see. Okay, so you can see kind of how, I'm gonna step by step and show. Okay, so all I did here is take a seaweed and I put some rice over it, okay? And I'm trying to spread it a little evenly, so you know, you wanna make a good roll without rice pockets. And then, so in your kit, you get a sushi roller. The sushi roller looks like this. A bit of a pro tip, if you ever wanna make sushi, wrap your sushi roller with cellophane, this way your rice doesn't stick on it. So I have the cellophane, I have the sushi. Now I'm gonna flip it upside down so that the rice is on the inside, the seaweed's on the outside. Then what I'm going to do is my crab meat. Cucumber.
And I have some avocado. So I just want to quickly show you guys kind of lined up like this. Everything is like very, they're snugly next to each other. Okay. And then what you basically do is you just roll the sushi so that you do it once. You got to leave a little edge here. This edge is important because this makes sure that your roll sticks together. Okay, so I have a little edge and we're just gonna roll it over one more time. So once you roll it twice, you have everything kind of like rolled up like this. You're ready to cut. So I'm just gonna cut my roll really quick. I have to tell you guys, I did not wrap this as tightly as I should have because I think I was trying to hold it up. But anyhow, so I cut my sushi into a few pieces. And as you'll see, it doesn't look very good because I put a little too much rice, but hold on 1 second, I'm just gonna do something really quick. So, can't really see it, but there is my roll. I put a little too much rice, so that's my lesson learned. And what I wanna tell everybody here is when you get this kit, take a picture of your sushi and post it on Instagram and add the hashtag #NailedMySushi. I think it's a great way to see what everyone is doing. And every week we want to pick a winner. It could be, it might be the most professional. It might be sort of the biggest disaster, whatever it is, but the winner gets a $20 gift card to a Kai Lounge, which you can use at any time. You can use for takeouts, you can use for delivery. Just call us and tell us you have a gift card. And that's my little demo on my California roll.
That's awesome.
Great.
Gwen, how are we doing in your house?
So I'm just so excited to be here, but I have no idea what I'm doing. I don't know if Lillian can see my board.
I can Lillian, see it.
Do I have this set up the right way? Do I have I put the carrot in the cucumber?
You got it. You got it. Now
before,
you...
before I even get to that, I have to get to my drink.
That's but, right. Cheers.
Lillian hooked me up with a lychee martini. So I'm going to just pour it in here so you guys can see, because I think when you drink and cook, it all makes everything taste good, even if it's not very good looking.
That's
good.
Right. That's so, right.
So cheers to you, Lillian.
Cheers to you, Gwen. Thank you so much. Enjoy.
And then I'm going to roll this sushi and you guys just.
So Gwen. Gwen, move the little flowers in front of you. So we move the little flowers in front of you. There you go.
Fancy, you know, but
I am. That's beautiful.
But I'll do this. So I have no idea. So this is probably going to be a mess. Is this the right way, Lillian?
I see you. Typically, you want to roll you want to roll outwards, but listen, you were just trying to make a roll. So whatever makes it stack.
Outward, this way?
Yeah.
Okay, wait. Okay, I'm going to try. But one thing that Lillian told me is to have a little bit of water because the rice will stick to your fingers.
Right.
So you want to dip your fingers into like a little thing of water. So I tried that. So I just want to remind you. And she actually has a little handy dandy cheat sheet that she provides with her kit. So you guys should take advantage of that as well. And now what do I do? Just what do I do?
Let's unroll it and see what happens.
Okay. Oh my God. Oh my goodness.
Nailed it. Nailed it.
This is a disaster waiting to happen. Nothing happened.
So Gwen, I have to tell
I probably am still eating. So what am I supposed to do? Cut it?
Yep, just cut it. Or another thing you can do, just so you know, when your roll doesn't work this way, you can always roll it together like an ice cream cone like this and you make a hand roll.
Oh.
Uh-huh.
That's good. But you guys, I need more time. I didn't get any practice, but This is the sushi. It's definitely needs a lot of work.
Do a hand roll.
Do a hand roll. You got it.
Yeah. See, you know, this looks good too. So, yeah. I just want to taste a little bit, but it's good. And I even actually have some soy sauce sitting here to the side to dip it in. But take another bite. I've eaten at Lillian's restaurant, Akai, and it's delicious. Highly recommend it. And definitely highly recommend this. It's a fun thing to do. I have 4 kids and they all love sushi. So this is a terrific idea and terrific idea for Girls Night In as well. Fun, because I can see a lot of laughs.
Thank you.
Martini and your sushi roll in front of you.
Oh, Gwen, you're amazing. Thank you so much. And like I mentioned before, through my Instagram, you can go to the link at my bio and it'll take you to very short videos to show you how to actually make this in more detail. So you'll see it up close how we do this.
Yes. Sure. Yes. Lots of fun.
The Akai Lounge is open for pickup and delivery.
Yeah, we're open for curbside pickup, no contact delivery, 4 to 8 every day.
Excellent. And hopefully soon the restaurant will open.
Yes, hopefully soon. In the meantime, you know, you could call us for our cocktails. We have the lychee martini. I have our Japanese whiskey cocktail drink here, but give us a call.
Excellent.
Love it.
Excellent.
Love
Thank
it.
You, Lily.
Thank you.
Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you. Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye. So we're almost at the end of our program. We just have a great musical interlude coming up, which in a second. Which I'll tell you about. And then tonight, ladies, you can party. You can really, really party on your virtual girls' night at parties. I hope that you all have them set up because I think it's a great idea. And I think you'll have a blast. And I hope today was a blast too. I think it was. I haven't had this much fun on a computer screen in a long time. I just want to give some thanks to some people before we introduce our final presenters. I want to thank Mayor Shelley Brindle and Councilwoman Dawn Mackey and Councilwoman Linda Habgood and Gwen for participating with us today. I want to thank all of our fabulous merchants who were with us today. Thank you for participating with us. We are doing our best under very trying circumstances to keep you guys going and get you sales and keep business afloat. So I wanted to thank you, all of the merchants. I wanna thank Riley Kopser, who was a volunteer with us, and Mike Bielan from the Westfield IT department. And I have 3 special thanks. I really, really wanna thank my 2 staff members, Nikki McAuliffe and Beth Brenner, who were really just outstanding during this whole, putting this whole thing together. We put this together in 2 weeks and pretty incredible. And a real special thank you to Mark Friedberg, who is head of our town's technical advisory committee. Mark is a volunteer and has spent, I have no idea how many hours on this project making this work. And it worked. It really did work. I don't know, Mayor, if you have any closing comments before we introduce our final presenter, but I just want to thank you, Mark, for all your help with this.
No, and obviously thanks to you, Bob, for leading us. And I think what you said about Mark and everybody else, I mean, it really is most of the, all, a lot of the efforts you see behind the scenes are from a lot of volunteers. And I think there were the common thread beyond the great products and services that we saw today was really what people say about how supported and appreciated and loved these merchants feel by our community. And I just can't thank our community enough for doing that, because that, you know, that becomes the inspiration for all of them to show up every day and work probably 10 times harder than they ever have for, you know, for half of what they're accustomed to getting. So it really is thanks to our community that we're going to get through this. So, and this is just an example of that. And I had a great time today. It was fun. I learned a lot. I still can't get over the bang thing with the hair. I'll be trying that one. But anyway, thank you, Bob, too, for leading the way.
Thank you. Thank you, Shelley. And to close us out today in a wonderful ukulele sing-along, I am pleased to present Kelly and Jose Valencia from the Valencia Music School in Westfield, who are going to lead us in with ukuleles. And hopefully we'll learn the songs and we can sing along.
Thank you so
Kelly
much.
And Jose, take it away.
Thank you so much, Bob. Yeah, we have a lot of guitars on screen. There will be a little guitar because that's our wheelhouse. But we're going to give you, Jose's actually, for anybody who has a ukulele at home, he's just going to show you a couple things that we do. He's going to show you a couple chords. And then that way, if anyone is at home with a ukulele, they can totally play along. But I'm going to let Jose take the hot seat for a moment. Sorry, I can't move the chair over because our dog has decided that he's going to be part of the show on the floor. So.
Okay.
Hey, Westfield, how's it going? I hope you guys are enjoying girls' night. Ladies' night, I should say.
Yes.
Hope you got your cocktails. All right, so real quick, I'm just going to show you a couple of cool things on the ukulele. The great thing about this is that it's very easy to play. Doesn't take a lot of pressure, and a lot of the chords are easy. So we're going to start with a C chord. So it's very easy. We take our ring finger, and you see the little squares here. They're called frets. So what we're going to do is we're going to find the bottom string, and we're going to take our third finger and hold that. Sorry, how long was I muted for?
A few seconds.
Okay. So,
just a few seconds.
Okay, cool. So like I said, we're going to take our ring finger and hold this third square here on the bottom string, and then we're gonna take our thumb and we're just gonna strum. Just like that, nice and easy. All right, so that's our first chord. Our second chord, very easy. We're gonna take our middle finger and we're just gonna hold the second fret. And then we're gonna strum every string. So we got C, C major 7, and then after that, we're gonna play the A minor, and what we do is we take this middle finger and we just jump across the fretboard up to the top string. Hold that second fret, make sure you don't block any of the other strings, and we strum again. All right, so again, we got C, C major 7. Then we take our middle finger, we jump across the strings. And then what we do is the last chord, F, while we're holding our middle finger down, we're going to take our index finger and we're going to hold the second string from the bottom, 1, 2, right here. We're going to hold the first fret and place our first finger down. And then we get F. So again, we got A minor here. And then we add our first finger, second string, first fret. And there we go. We have those four chords. So we got C, C major 7, and then we got A minor. And then hold our middle finger down, and then we're going to add our index finger here, first fret, second string. All right. So now that we took care of the left hand, we're going to talk about the right hand. Very simple. All we're going to do is we're going to strum each chord 8 times, okay? So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Switch. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Switch. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We'll do it one more time for the cheap seats in the back. Here we go. C, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7. Switch. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And jump. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go. Give yourselves a round of applause, right? All right, so.
Don't worry, we're not going to try to teach you anything else. Don't worry, we won't try to teach you anything else. Now it's just sing along time. We know you guys have learned a lot today. So,
what we're going to do is we're going to strum through these chords a little faster. We're going to pick up the tempo a little bit. We're going to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
The guitar a little bit and do what is really our wheelhouse. I know we said ukulele sing along, but you know, there's so many cool songs that we can actually do on guitar too. So yeah,
Jose, Kelly,
break out the guitar. Yeah,
Kelly, this is Mark. Okay. I just added everybody who is watching.
Oh, okay.
Join. So let's try this. So all the viewers, if you want to join video only, we'll have a montage of every person who's on this call.
Okay.
Well, that would be so cool.
Okay. You'll be the highlight in the middle. So.
Oh, I like that.
but everybody's got to mute. So maybe we'll see more than, here we go. People are showing up, video only.
And are the levels okay, sound-wise?
Sound is good, yeah. Awesome. I'm going to go to mute and turn it back to you. People can lip sync.
We love it.
Out loud. Okay, good luck.
Thanks. So we're big 90s buffs, and and so there might be a couple 90s songs in here. But hey, if you have anything you want to hear, I'm sure that you can send in a request for...
Okay, one last note. So everybody out there, just, you know, turn your video on, and I see some people joining. Okay, I'll get out of the way.
No problem. All right, so we're just going to do a couple of 90s songs. Just a little bit about, real quick, while Jose changes everything over and makes sure it's all tuned up. Right now, we have 50% off of the first four lessons until this, if anyone contacts us by Sunday. So if you're going a little stir crazy and need something to occupy your time, we're totally going to give 50% off of all new students' first four lessons. As long as you shoot us an email, you can hop onto our website, valenciamusicnj.com. And we just love it when our Westfield family grows. So, all right. An old man turned 98. He won the lottery and died the next day. It's a black fly in your Chardonnay. The death row party. Well, isn't this nice? And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? He's like me. Everything's gone wrong and everything blows up in your face. A traffic jam when you're already late. A no smoking sign on your cigarette break. It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife. It's meeting the man of my dreams and then meeting his beautiful wife. Isn't it ironic? Don't you think? A little too ironic. And yeah, I really do think it's like rain. Our next one. Oh, thank you. I can see you clapping. So our next one is one of my favorites. So we picked all female singers to choose from, and this is one of my all-time favorites because I am just a huge Janis fan. And yeah, let's do it. Hopefully a couple of you know a little about Bobby McKee. Busted flat in Baton Rouge, waiting for a train, and I was feeling near as faded. From the Kentucky. This is a big favorite. And, you know, we're trying to pick something from a couple different eras. I'm a big 90s girl, like I said. But we're big on the 90s, but we try to pick a couple different eras. And, yeah, so we'll do one more for you.
Okay.
Sometimes I go out by myself and I look across the water. And I think of all the things, what you're doing. In my head I paint a picture. Since I've come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over, stop making a fool out of me. Put your house on up for sale. Did you get a good lawyer? Hope you didn't catch a tan. Hope you found the right man who will fix it for you. Are you shopping anywhere? Change the color of your hair. Are you busy? Did you have to pay? Come on home, well, my body's been a mess. And I miss your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over, stop making a fool out of me. Why don't you come on over, your ginger hair and the way you like to dress. Won't you come on over, stop making a fool out of me. Why won't you come on over, Valerie. Much Westfield. We timed that out kind of perfectly. So again, we are so happy to be a part of this community. It is just everything to us. We miss everyone so much, but we know that when we come back together, it's going to be stronger than we ever imagined. So have a great time tonight, and can't wait to see you ladies in the bars when we get back. Thank you.
Kelly and Jose from Valencia Music School. Thank you very much. That was really great.
Amazing. Thank you. Great. Brilliant.
To end this off. And I again want to thank everybody on the screen and everybody who's not on the screen, but who was on the screen or who watched on Facebook, all our merchants, our staff, everybody, all our volunteers. It was amazing. I hope you all have fun tonight.
Yes.
go order some food from some of these great restaurants, order some takeout drinks. I see Dawn's got hers, and go have a blast. Thanks, everybody.
Bye, everyone. Bye.